Streams in the desert. You know, it's so much easier to share what you do know than it is to share what you don't know. Often, what people will do with information, and information is just simply data. Information is those things that are said to inform. That's why we have the word information. Information. When it comes to information, it can go a variety of ways. You see, if you're giving data, then it can be examined for facts, because data will produce a result. When you compile it, it becomes a fact, or it becomes a premise, and you can examine it and prove it. But sometimes when we hear things, we don't always hear what we think we heard, or we put a spin on it by accident. Our own personality invades it, and somehow it becomes changed into something it's not. And that's what happened in Jesus' day, was that God had revealed himself in the Torah, in the Old Testament, in all of the examples that he had given in life, in recording history, in demonstrating God's love from Adam all the way through to, we'll say, the birth of Jesus, and how he had revealed his mercy, his love, his grace, and his plan for mankind. And yet, in some respects, most people treated God as being austere, not loving, and very hateful, and very holy, frankly. And yet, we find in the conversations that Moses had that he was able to intercede for the children of Israel, and they were saved because he said, look, you don't want to wipe them out. Or like when Abraham negotiated with the Lord in not allowing Lot to be destroyed, but rather bargained for the entire city to be saved. That even if there were so many sinners and there were at least a few righteous, would not the God of heaven and earth, the God of love, really, that we would say, would he not do righteously? And so the point being is that God hasn't changed him. He isn't this different father that he was back then, and now he's suddenly a father because of Jesus. No, Jesus came to reveal that we had gotten the information about God wrong. We had not understood what God was saying all along, and so he had sent his prophets to try to tell us. He had sent his word to us. He had given us his examples. He had shown us people's lives. He had written down everything that they did and shown how he was still a God of love and mercy, and yet we still couldn't accept it. So then Jesus came. And you know, today we still have legalism, and we still have laws, and we still have people that are misunderstanding what God's love is and what God has done for us and how God wants us to be understanding of who he is. God is love. If there's anything that you should grasp in dealing with other people, is to love not just them, but to love your father, so that when your father loves you, he can take care of you and provide for you and abide with you in all that you're doing, so that you'll be able to love those that don't love you, that maybe hate you because they have wrong information about you, even as God was portrayed in a wrong way until Jesus came and revealed the heart of the Father. Sometimes our hearts need to be revealed, that we have changed from what we were, which was our heart was deceitful and corrupt and wickedly made, and that God has put a new heart inside of us. A new tenderness, a new gentleness towards other people, towards our enemies, towards those whom God loves. And maybe sometimes that little heart is still deep inside, but gradually it will come out that God is love, and that you need to be aware of that, so that your information is always founded, centered, and directed towards love, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But that love would draw men to repentance. God is our refuge and strength, the very present help in trouble. The question often comes, why didn't he help me sooner? It is not his order. He must first adjust you to the trouble and cause you to learn your lesson from it. His promise is, I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. He must be with you in trouble first, all day and all night. Then he will take you out of it. This will not come till you have stopped being restless and fretful about it and become calm and quiet. Then he will say, okay, it's enough. God uses trouble to teach his children precious lessons. They are intended to educate us. When their good work is done, a glorious recompense will come to us through them. There is a sweet joy and real value in them. He does not regard them as difficulties, but as opportunities. Not always out of our... that's a poem. We once heard a simple colored man say something that we have never forgotten. When God tests you, it's a good time for you to test him by putting his promises to the proof and claiming from him just as much as your trials have rendered necessary. There are two ways of getting out of a trial. One is to simply try to get rid of the trial and be thankful when it's over. The other is to recognize that the trial is a challenge from God to claim a larger blessing than we ever have, and to hail with it delight as an opportunity of obtaining a larger measure of divine grace. Thus, even the adversary becomes an auxiliary, and things that seem to be against us turn out to be the furtherance of our way. Surely this is to be more than conquerors through him who loved us. And as you go through trials and experience them, then you know that they're just lessons you're learning in order to grow in the knowledge of him as you continually walk with him personally. No one can cause you to walk in a certain way. Only you can determine which way you will walk. Today, as you learn to listen to him, to do as he says, and to choose to follow his way. It's not about following some man's way or some church's way or some religion's way or some ideas that you have, but rather each day take the day as it is and accept that it's God's way to reveal to you what he would have you to be today as he's revealing in you himself and how you can depend upon him for everything in your day as you walk with him today. It's pretty simple. Just develop that personal relationship with him. Don't go your way. Go his way.